Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Candia police are crediting a young teenage girl with doing the right thing after she was pulled over by someone impersonating a police officer. The man allegedly tried to get the girl out of her car, but she refused. The stop took place late at night along Route 27 in Candia near the Hooksett Town line, and Ray Brewer has the story.
It makes me a little nervous because I work in a store and I close late at night and end up walking home, so kind of scares me a little bit.
Just down the road from the store where Amanda Tucker works is where Candia police say the police impersonator pulled a young girl over.
She said the guy was dressed as a police officer, had a badge, did not have a flashlight, did not ask for a license or registration, was driving a dark-colored sedan. Did have blue lights.
The chief says the stop happened Friday night on Route 27 near the Hooksett Town line. The chief says the fake officer also failed to turn a spotlight on the car which he had pulled over, which is standard operating procedure for police officers. Then the impersonator tried to get the teenage girl out of the car.
Leaned into the vehicle, asked her several times to get out of the vehicle, grabbed her seatbelt. She refused. She did the right thing. She got scared. She rolled the window up, locked the door, and left.
Police say the girl described the man as around 6 feet tall with a medium to thin build with dark hair. Police say the girl's story was backed up by a witness who noticed the traffic stop and told police about it when he saw an officer on an unrelated matter. The girl and the witnesses both say the sedan had flashing blue lights, but unlike Candia cruisers, the lights were not on the roof. Instead, the chief says they were mounted on the grill or dashboard. The chief says at this point they're not sure what the man intended. But until he's caught, Amanda Tucker says she will make sure she's not walking home alone.
The Candia chief says if you suspect the person pulling you over is not a police officer, then you should drive to a brightly lit area and call 911. An autopsy is underway on the body of an elderly woman found dead Saturday after a fire broke out in her Manchester home. Authorities have identified the victim as 80-year-old Frances Cross. Officials managed to contain the fire at her Brown Avenue home within minutes. It's believed the fire started somewhere in the kitchen. An important tourist highway in the North Country has reopened a week ahead of schedule. The Kankamagas Highway was significantly damaged by flooding from Tropical Storm Irene, but now traffic is flowing freely between Lincoln and Conway. A temporary pedestrian bridge has also been put in place where the Loon Mountain Bridge once stood. Further north, Route 302 remains closed, but officials say it should reopen by the end of the month, just in time for the fall foliage season. The Patriots are in Florida to open the Monday night football schedule against the Dolphins. The Dolphins' 1-7 record in their own stadium a year ago was the NFL's worst. And the last time the Patriots faced the Dolphins, the Pats won 38-7. Tonight's kickoff is at 7 o'clock. Over the weekend, there were some incredible displays of patriotism at NFL games where large American flags were unrolled over the fields. Well, starting tonight at 5, some disturbing news about one type of breast cancer. New research finds more evidence of a strong genetic connection, making diagnosis an immediate family matter. We'll have the details on this coming up tonight at 5 o'clock. That does it for this webcast. Thanks for joining us and have a great afternoon.